Solve the system of equations. Enter your answer as an ordered pair, coordinate notation. Now let's look here. X minus y equals 0, negative 3x minus y equals 2. The y's, they're pretty close to having the coefficients we need, except they're both negative, so I'm going to multiply the first equation through by negative 1. So it'll be negative x plus y, and then still equals 0. And then I'm going to rewrite the second equation, negative 3x minus y equals 2. So now add vertically, negative x, and then plus negative 3x, that's the same as subtracting 3x, so negative 4x, and then plus y minus y makes 0, and then equals 2. Divide by negative 4 on both sides, x equals negative 1/2. So now to find the y value, I'm going to use this first equation. I'm going to substitute the negative 1/2 for x and then solve for y. So the equation is x minus y equals 0, and I'll substitute negative 1/2 in for x, so negative 1/2 minus y equals 0. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and add y to both sides, because that'll be the quickest way to solve for y. Add y to both sides. So negative 1/2 equals y. So this is your answer. Negative 1/2, negative 1/2 again. So let's just check real quick. Negative 1/2, and then it's minus negative 1/2 is plus 1/2, equals 0. So it works in the first equation. Now the second equation, put in a negative 1/2 in here, it's going to be negative 3, and then times negative 1/2, minus negative 1/2, equals 2. So 3 times negative 1/2, that's positive 3/2, and then minus negative 1/2, that's plus 1/2, equals 2. 3/2 plus 1/2, so that does make 2. 2 equals 2. So you know for sure this is the correct solution for the system of equations. So now we're going to graph the equation to verify the solutions. X-intercept, x equals 0. Y-intercept, negative y equals 0, so that also means y equals 0. Well, that's not very useful for drawing a graph if the both intercepts are 0. You need two points that are not the same to draw the line. You know, one point's here. So I'm going to try a different approach here. I'm going to try and solve it so it's in slope-intercept form. So x minus y equals 0, add y to both sides. I'm going to get x equals y, which also can be written as y equals x. Okay, so that one, y equals x, has an initial amount, or y-intercept of 0, and the rate of change is 1. So the graph looks just like that. That's y equals x. Now I'll switch colors for the second one. We have negative 3x equals 2, so divide by negative 3. X equals negative 2/3. We'll talk about graphing that in just a minute. For the y-intercept, we have negative y equals 2, so divide by negative 1. Positive y equals 2 divided by negative 1, or negative 2. Okay, so let's talk about plotting this x equals negative 2/3. I'm going to estimate that to be about negative 0.6, which would be about right there. And the y is negative 2 right there. Now you have to be careful when you're plotting decimals, especially that close to 0. Because if you're off by a little bit, when it's a smaller number, that mistake compounds itself. So it'll seem like a bigger mistake than it really is. Okay, so there's a point of intersection. Kind of hard to see what it is because it's not integers. However, the answer that we found solving algebraically was negative 1/2, negative 1/2. And if we look where this intersection is, negative 1/2, negative 1/2 is a reasonable answer. It's right there, very close to 0, 0. It does look like for the x it's negative 1/2, and also for the y, it looks like negative 1/2. So I would say this is a valid answer. Something like this, if you weren't sure, you could also substitute in your calculator to verify.